Coming to next one, rectangular waveguides. A rectangular waveguide supports TM and TE modes, but not TEM waves because we cannot define a unique voltage since there is only one conductor inside a rectangular waveguide. And the shape of rectangular waveguide is as shown below figure, next figure. Okay. And in that material, a material with permittivity E and permeability M fills inside of this conductor. Permittivity and permeability E and M. Okay, let us assume from this, just you need to remember this A value is greater than to B. Assume that. Let us consider the shape of the rectangular waveguide above with dimensions A and B. Assume that A is greater than B. And the parameters E and M, permittivity and permeability. So for the, let us assume if you want to calculate TM mode equation, you need to assume that in the Z direction, electromagnetic field Hz of vector is equal to 0 and Ez should be calculated from the solved equations. This you need to remember, this equation. From that, since Ez of xyz is equal to Ez naught of xy into e power minus gz, from that we will get it to this, the following equation: dou square by dou x square plus dou square by dou y square plus h square into e suffix x of xy is equal to z. If we use the method of separation of variable, that is e suffix z of x is equal to xy is equal to x of x into y of y, from that we will get it the expression. So the in this side we have only x terms, in this side we have only y terms. From that we need to differentiate d square into capital X of x divided by dx square plus k square suffix x of capital X of x is equal to 0, for same similar for y. Now we should solve for x and y from the preceding equations, and also we have the boundary conditions. These are the boundary conditions. Let us assume the here x value is equal to 0. Just you need to calculate for y. This is electric field in y direction. Let us assume if x value is equal to this 0, this x value is equal to A in the x direction. Now y is as it is, you need to assume that y only. For similar here, x is x, y equals 0. X is x here, y equals to b. You need to assume these are boundary conditions, so that the solution for z of x, y is equals to this. Just you need to remember. E naught sin of m pi divided by a into x into sin of n pi divided by b into y. From that, you need to define this expression. From that, you need to separate it. You need to send this side. This is sent to right side. H square is equal to, you will get it this, m pi by a whole square plus n pi by b whole square. From TM waves, we will get it this. In the x direction, in the y direction, what is the magnetic field or magnetic vector? These are the expressions. Next, the electric field expression for x direction and y direction, minus gamma divided by h square into dou ez divided by dou x square. Similar for y. Here we will get it only y axis, dou y. There is no different. Everything is same. Next, these are the expressions after substituting all the values in the equation. These are the expression, just you need to remember. whereas gamma is equals to j beta is equals to j into square root of omega square mu epsilon minus of m pi by a whole square minus m pi by b whole square. Here m and n represent the possible modes and it's designated as tm suffix m1 mode, and m denotes the number of half cycle variations of the field in the x direction, and n denotes the number of half cycle variations of the field in the y direction. When we observe the above equation, we see that for TM modes and rectangular waveguides, neither M or nor can be zero, nor at a time both will be zero. You need to remember that point. This is because of the fact that the field expression are identically zero if either M or N is zero, not both will be zero at a time. Therefore, the lowest move for rectangular waveguide TM mode is TM 11. Here the cutoff wave number is k suffix c is equals to square root of m pi by a whole square plus n pi b b whole square, and therefore beta is equals to square root of k square minus k suffix c whole square, and the cutoff frequency is at the point where g vanishes. Therefore f suffix c is equals to 1 by 2 into square root of epsilon mu into square root of m pi by a whole square plus n pi by b whole square hedges. Since if the L value is equals to mu divided by f means, you need to substitute that value, then you will get it the cutoff wavelength lambda suffix c is equals to 2 pi square root of m pi by a whole square plus n pi by b whole square in terms of meters. At a given operating frequency, you need to assume that f value only those frequencies which have fc is less than f will be propagated. If the mode with f less than fc will lead to an imaginary b, which means that the field component will decay exponentially and will not propagate. Such modes are called as cutoff or evanescent mode, and that mode with lowest cutoff frequency is called as dominant mode. Since TM move for rectangular waveguide starts from TM 11, we need to call that is a dominant mode, and the dominant mode frequency is fc suffix 11 is equals to 1 by 2 into square root epsilon mu into square root of, let us assume or substitute the m and values in that equation, you will get it 1 by a whole square plus 1 by b in terms of hedges. And the wave impedance is defined as the ratio of the transverse electric field to magnetic field. Therefore, we get from the expression from Ex and Hy. See the equation in the above. Just you need to remember. And the guided wavelength is defined as the distance between two equal planes along the waveguide, and it's equivalent to lambda suffix z is equals to 2 pi by beta, which is greater than 2 pi by k is equals to lambda. And the phase velocity v suffix p is equals to omega by beta, which is greater than omega by k, is equals to 1 by square root mu epsilon. And the attenuation for propagation mode results when there are losses in the dielectric and in imperfect conducting guide walls. And the attenuation constant due to the losses in the dielectric can be found as follows. This is the equation. Just you need to remember this. We already discussed. This is the third PPT from we are getting previously.